Welcome back to Cannes 2011. We're here in the thick of the brands. Today's subject matter, premiumization. What do brands do it for, and what do they get out of it? We're going to hear from some industry experts.
I think premiumization is a vital part of our marketing component. Grey Goose, probably the best example of premiumization. If you look at a brand like Grey Goose for us, today it is contributing over 80% of the category growth, and it is about 80% of the category of super premium vodka. So we're seeing a phenomenal growth.
Premiumization is, I think, is the nature of the game in nature of the humans. So you don't want to be going back to the Stone Ages because you want to go up to a next level of perceptions, and premiumization is part of that.
It's extremely a hot topic, premiumization, because essentially brands are just trying to out-premium each other. That is the name of the game, really. And I sometimes get frustrated with the word premium and the description of it, because, you know, what is premium? There is no absolute standard. You don't have to, you know, meet certain regulations in order to call your product premium. So, you know, it's all about a company's interpretation of that.